Welcome to the Grazing Game, a contest where you try to guess which plant-eating animal will finish their meal the fastest. Our first two competitors are both great grazers. They are Billy the Buffalo and ZZ the Zebra. It's time for you to pick which one of these animals you think will finish their food the fastest. All right, grazers, get ready, get set, go! It looks like ZZ the Zebra is off to a really fast start. She's doing great. It seems like Billy the Buffalo chews a lot slower, but takes some really big bites. Who is going to finish first? All I know is that it's going to be close. Wow! Billy the Buffalo stages a huge comeback. The winner this time is Billy. Up next is a challenge between two very tall grazers. A little higher, please. Yes, great, thank you. The challengers this time are Jesse Giraffe and Gerard Giraffe. Who do you choose to win? Ready, set, go! They're both munching away. Oh no, folks. It appears that a bee is distracting Gerard Giraffe. Okay, the bee is gone and Gerard Giraffe takes a huge bite. And he finishes all of the leaves on the branch. The winner this time is Gerard the Giraffe. This just in, folks. ZZ the Zebra has requested a rematch. For our final contest, the grazers again are Billy Buffalo and ZZ Zebra. Who do you think will finish their meal first? Okay, grazers, ready, set, go! They're both munching away. Will Billy the Buffalo come back once again? And ZZ Zebra finishes first. She is the winner. We hope you've had a good time playing the Grazing Game.
so alive with you. You're making all things brand new. So crazy to believe that nothing's ever gonna come between all the love that you have for me. It's a new day, and I'm feeling so alive with you. I'm feeling so alive with you.
One time, Jesus had been teaching many people all day. It was time to move on. So he told his disciples,
"Go to the other side of the lake. I will say goodbye to the people."
Later, when Jesus was alone, he went up into a nearby mountain to pray. And he was there until the evening, when the stars came out. Meanwhile, the disciples were in their boat making their way to the other side. But the wind was quite strong, and the ship was being tossed to and fro.
"It's getting pretty rough out here!
The water! It's getting into the ship! Help me, Thomas!"
I don't think we're gonna make it!
Peter, what do we do?"
"We've got to keep trying to get..." "What's that?"
"What's what?"
It's a ghost!
It's a ghost!"
When suddenly, they heard a familiar voice.
"Hello!"
"Quiet!"
"Listen!"
"Hello! It's me, Jesus. Don't be afraid."
And Peter answered,
"Lord, if it is you, let me come into the water to meet you."
"Come, Peter! Come!"
"What?"
So what did Peter do? Without a moment's hesitation, he swung over the boat, and to his amazement, he began to walk on the water. He was so happy to see Jesus again, and he made his way to the Lord quickly. When he was closer to Jesus, Peter realized what was happening.
"It isn't every day that something like this happens, and besides, who has ever walked on the water before? And, well, why would I, of all people, be able to?
Well, Peter started having doubts. He took his eyes off of Jesus and started looking at the waves instead.
Whoa! Oh, no!
And he began to sink.
Jesus! Jesus, please, help me! I'm sinking! Jesus!
Jesus stretched out his hand and caught poor Peter. Jesus lovingly said,
"Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?"
Jesus helped Peter get back on the ship, and as soon as they were in, guess what? All of a sudden, the wind calmed down, and the ship was once again floating smoothly. The disciples were so impressed, they came down and knelt at Jesus' feet and said,
"Truly, you are the Son of God."
Soon they were on the other side of the lake at a place called Gennesaret. When the people heard that Jesus was visiting, well, they came from all over the place and brought to him all the people that were sick and needed healing. Jesus loved the people and healed as many as came to him. Even people that touched the hem of his clothes were made well and walked away knowing that God loved and cared for each one of them in a very special way.
Hey, I need more cowbell. Thanks.
Here, a woof, there, a woof, everywhere, a woof, woof, Mr. Noah had a knock. land. It could have been you. He wore a coat.